and welcome to Castalia. We are a portal who connects with creative people and give them right opportunity and platform to show what they are. So come and join where passion meets opportunity. Today we have Shri Ravi Faransbe, an eminent artist, illustrator, writer and owner of the Ravi Faransbe Art Studio. I'm sure you want to know more about him. So let's come and talk to him. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
So sir, everybody in this industry knows you are an artist. So how did that thought came in your mind, like how you started as a painter and how did you evolve?
Who felt it? I'll briefly tell you about my writing.
Yeah.
I was not born as a writer, although my father was. Right. I never took to writing during my career. Till 1987, I never wrote any article. Maybe in college days, I must have contributed one or two small articles. But that, beyond that, nothing. In 1987, as I told you, there was an article in my book, which I was mentioned derogatively.
Yeah.
And that was, that I said, I must go answer that. That's how I wrote my first article in my book. Earlier, although I wanted to write, my father opposed.
Okay.
He said, your reading is not up to that point.
Okay.
So you don't try, make an attempt to write, because you will invite a lot of criticism by others, and you will not be able to answer that correctly. Or you will be wasting your time in non-productive things.
Correct.
So he said, you better concentrate on your illustration work. It's going on very well.
Well.
So I followed that. But in 1987, my father expired. And later on, this article came. So I had nobody to guide me.
Correct. Your father was an inspiration for you.
So my inner self was telling me that I should write back, give a reply to that.
Right.
And that things clear for the public. So I wrote that. Before that I had written a small letter.
Uh-huh.
The same effect. But friends told me that you have written a small letter. The subject involved is behind that you write an article.
Right.
So I had wrote that up.
Got to know that
you write also. Yes.
So,
which was the first award what you got for the book? Yes. There was a book called Prashmi Mileage. So, you got an award of Saidu Ratna Damini Award, the Mani Award. So, could you tell us about the book and,
Actually, I was never writing before 1990. So, when did you start it? You know, that thought came in your mind, you know, that I can write.
No, it so happened that there was an article appeared in Maharashtra Times, in which my name was mentioned derogatively. The article was about the status of art in Maharashtra. And the writer has said that artists like Dalal, Ravi Faransbe, have created a place for themselves, which doesn't allow other artists to come up.
Okay.
Huh? Which is a falsehood actually. Other artists were working. But I had the distinction of having my own style.
Of course.
That should have been, I think, recognized by the writer.
Yeah.
He did do that. And he attributed false that I am a commercial artist.
Okay.
And not a painter. Like this.
Okay.
So this posed another challenge before.
But there will be a lot of stories why you know, evolve. That point of time, there are a lot of stories which, you know, that about you would have come up.
Yes, you
like
know,
this.
I told you, the main story was that by 1980, I had obtained a name and a reputation in the field of art also.
Right.
Because few paintings were exhibited. along with my other work for Applied Art, was going very strong. And all sorts of challenges I had met till then. I had a name as an illustrator. Many people were asking me that I should hold in the tradition of my because it has that
quality. Yeah, because if there's good quality, people gonna come and approach you.
Many artists used to tell me, my father, he said, you must have your own
exhibition. Sir, is your father, was your inspiration?
Very much. All my cultural side, it has got a great impact from my father.
So your father was a painter?
He was a teacher,
okay.
High school teacher.
Okay.
Then for a while he worked as a professor of Hindi in college. But he was a very culturally known person. Many people used to recognize him.
Correct?
It was called Shikhare Rangareshanji. Correct? So could you tell us about that also? Oh yes. That was a great challenge for me and great pleasure. How do you perceive modern art and tradition? According to you. As I was telling you, my feeling is that art is for developing a taste of the masses. Be heightened, keep on heightening. And that work is done by what is known as classicism. So classicism has to be there in every artistic field.
So classicism, according to you, how, what?
It has to be explained. Classicism in painting is about space management. You know, pictorial canvas is a space.
Correct.
You have to utilize that space in such a manner that the spectator will get glued to the painting. This is the problem of stress creation in the painting. So that is classicism. And only when that happens in a painting, people will. People are bound to watch it carefully. They will not just stop themselves by passing by. They all check and see what is there.
Yes.
Once they get good to think, they enjoy it.
Enjoy. You should feel, you know, enjoy while watching it. You know,
yes.
It should be so aesthetically.
They come to know so many small things which have been put into the book with great mental deliberation.
You should connect with the problem. Last question to you.
Yes.
So Ravi Paranthi Studio was found with a mission as the design based concept.
Yes.
So could you elaborate?
Yes, that is a very important question. As you will also agree with me, if you study our national life on the streets of any place, you will find there are lot of problems arising out of the fact that Indians don't have a design sense. For instance, today what I heard about an old building fell down in water. Yes, till the time I heard it, there were some 7 deaths. So many people injured, and about 30, 40 people were buried inside the buildings. Why it happened? Because we don't have design-based structure.
Concept.
Actually speaking, the municipality has informed the residents of that building that it is not worth living anymore. You better make other arrangements. And leave the building. You will ask somebody, new building. Probably you would share of the place will be there. COVID vaccine. People lived in the world did not accept this. They could not understand the seriousness of the matter. Why? Because they don't have the vaccines.
Stay tuned with us for more interesting interviews like this. Till then, see you next time.